By sacred, I again mean only significant or meaningful. I don't mean any religious or moral sense. But it is that, because that which is at random, what is at random, is making this whole thing meaningless. But in the life that we are living, there is nothing but randomness today. Vibrance is random, our lives are random, our developments are random. I mean, there is so much randomness in our life today. It has become totally unstructured. And in fact, if we cannot make a film, this random development of mobiles, for example, I'm not disturbed by it, and that's what I'm trying to say. That this randomness, in fact, is not a disturbance. In fact, I'm trying to say how to include this randomness, how to make this randomness a part of our expression, a part of our meaning. How can we, for example, include this and then make a new kind of a whole that is able to embrace this uncertainty, randomness, and not go by structure, idea, ideation, you know, and just make a film which is one idea, you know. That, I think, will only happen if we find a new relationship with the idea of duration, time, and think that how if a shot starts and lasts for a certain time, like music, for example, there's only tone, but how long the phrase lasts, how long somebody is using something, how short it is, how long, what we call in music, which I'm also very involved in, you know, like in particularly in Swat, which is a North Indian form of music, and it is actually based on recitative traditions. And recitation itself is dependent upon what we call ris and dhiri, you know, there are three forms of it. But there are many other factors that are temporal, that describe time. How can time affect, you know, our narration? How can we actually not care for the idea of the composition and include the randomness? How can somebody acting give me a sense of the kind of attention, the quality of attention? Once the quality, what are we looking for in a work of art? I think it's that particular quality of attention that the work is able to generate. That's the power of a work of art. That when you see, it's not a question of, somebody could be preoccupied with some political issues, social issues, that's another matter. But ultimately, if it's a work of art, it is a certain quality of attention, and it is able to displace. And it is this attention that is at stake, because it is faced with that kind of randomness. And how can we include this, you know? And I think this can only happen if we are going to look at cinema in a completely different way now. I have a feeling, somehow, I'm not too sure, because I'm a film man, and most of my films I made in 35mm, like all of us. I didn't even, I think, probably made one film in 16. I think that the new development of the digital has something in it that fascinates me. And I'm not too certain as to how can it solve this problem. But the idea of fragment, for example, which was in our minds during the time you make films, like a fragment is a shot. And a shot is very important. A shot is a spatial, like made of space, fragment, which is very important for film. So, and it's a construction of such fragments. So that when we take a shot, it's very important to say, start camera. And when we end the shot, we also very important, cut it. And in fact, often directors, when they say, cut it, or whatever expression they have, you can almost know whether he likes the shot or doesn't like it, you know. So that becomes a very structured sort of space, you know, that he has created. When you look at video, I mean, it's ridiculous. Nobody will say, start video, cut it. It doesn't make sense. Fragment doesn't make any sense anymore, because the whole relationship with the space is altered. The video is forever. You put it on, it goes on for 1 hour at least, minimum. And now they're doing the hard disk. It will go on all day, maybe. Where there is no notion of the fragment anymore. So the idea of duration is completely altered. Whereas we were dealing with fragments, now we don't have to deal with them. So that there is nothing that I can tell an actor, for example, that within this shot, you have to do this. That's not the idea anymore, you know. I mean, it will take on a completely different form altogether. The story will take on a different form, the whole idea of shop taking will take on difference. Shop itself will lose meaning to my mind, you know. Will that happen with the digital? Can cinema do it? You know, I'm very uncertain. But I, to this very wonderful occasion, wanted to raise this question and perhaps have a dialogue with you. I'll stop here now and I'll be very glad to answer, join you in a dialogue if you have any questions. Thank you.